door season, open door season. So many doors seem to be closing, but God in Holy Week has opened the door. And this is Pastor Mark B.C. Taylor, pastor of the Church of the Open Door.
Hallelujah.
The open door possibilities to you, you, and even you. So we're glad we're back at what we call an overflow. We had an hour-long Bible study, hour-long plus. Amen. And just want to tell you something we were talking about. Deacon Flowers was telling me how he went to a family birthday celebration on Sunday, and he began to pray. All his family was there, and he just lifted his hand and started praying. And I was saying these are the kinds of things we must do for our young people. We don't want to raise a generation that does not know God. Our children know more about games. They know more about what's that thing that they were playing and they were running in the cars because they were looking for Pokemon. Were they looking for Pokemon? They're looking for Pikachu.
Pokemon Go.
They were looking for Pokemon.
Yeah.
People were getting hit by cars.
Yeah.
They was falling on bridges and stuff, falling down ledges. Because they were looking for Pokemon and couldn't look up. I was like, listen, our kids are playing games 2 and 3 hours a day. We got to get them ready to deal with the struggles of life. We got to get them ready to deal with one of the things you think about. Our parents had Easter. We had to go to Easter programs. We had to have Easter parts. We had to do all of these things to learn how to live in a crooked, hostile world. And a lot of us, we have not prepared our children for that world at home. Not at all. And then, you know, when something happens, we want to run to the church and say, do something. No, something should have been done years ago.
Yes.
And so I'm concerned that we get concerned about the spiritual development of our young people. Because, you know, having stuff is not going to make you strong enough to gain victory in life. And we gain victory because our people sought hard after God. And our people learned about God. So I want to tell you that. Challenge your young people with who God is. Start to talk about God. Now you might say, well, I don't know what to say. Stumble your way into it. Fumble and mumble. Rumble. There was a newscast. When somebody would run towards the end zone of football, he would say, there you go. Rumble and bumble and stumble your way into talking about God. Do stuff that they don't expect. Take people off course. Take people off guard. Pray with people. Ask people, do they know the Bible stories? But see, for some of this, you got to know the Bible stories yourself.
That's right.
Tell them the story of Jonah swallowed by the fish. Tell them the story of Samson picking up the gates of the city on his shoulders. They all know the story of David and Goliath. A lot of us don't know. Tell the story about Isaiah having to walk around naked for a long period of time. Tell them the story about God telling Ezekiel to eat dung so he can give a message to the people. Hosea had to marry a whore, a prostitute, okay? Tell these kind of stories to people, especially our children, so that they will know how God operates. Tell them what Jesus said. Show them what Jesus did. Make them ask you questions. Why are you doing that? One of the things I did when I came to this church, I started teaching children how to lay hands. And the children who I taught how to lay hands are now 35 and 40. And some of them really got it. They're laying hands on their children. They're praying for their family members. These are the things you have to teach. Don't worry about them shaking their booty. The world gonna teach them that. You better teach them something about God. And I want you to be intentional and be bold in this. Because you and I are doing what? We're going off the scene.
That's it.
Was it Plato that said the world's a stage and everybody play their part and then they go exit stage left? Yeah, your part might be getting to the close. So get your children ready to carry on. All right, that's my little commercial about that. Questions about tonight. Questions about foot washing, laying on the hands, waving palms. No questions? Okay, no questions. But I want you to ask me some questions. That's what I'm telling you. Because many of us, when I came here, this was not a church given to open praise of God. It took me many years to tell people why they should praise God. And again, I think it's hard. Many people in this church have a Methodist orientation, and some of them still do. I'm mad at you, but if you learn how to praise God, it does something for you. If you learn how to, the other day, it was a song by LaShawn Mitchell called "He Got Up." Death could not hold me, my Savior got up. And I wanted to hear this record on Easter, and I had plugged my phone into my computer and messed up my playlist. And so I had to find the song, but I found it. I said, well, let me find this song. And I got up and I started to shout, I started to dance, because I believe I need to shout in my house. Ain't no need to come to church shouting in front of you when I can't shout in my house. Ain't no need to come to church praising God in front of you and I can't break out in my house. So I had to break out in my house in my dance. I had to dance in advance. I knew the Lord was going to bless the service. I knew Holy Week was being blessed. But I had to give me a blessing from dancing. Hey, shout out, oh, blah, 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 blah. I had to give me a blessing from dancing in the Lord. That's the kind of thing. The Lord said, what you do in secret, God will reward you openly. He said, pray to me in secret, I will reward you openly. Praise Him in secret, He'll reward you openly. And one of the things that I want God to do in the open, in the public things that I do, I want the power of God to be there. So I got to do things in secret when it's just me and God. And you do too. You want to gain victory in every area of your life, make sure you meet God at your prayer time. Make sure you meet God in the Word. Make sure you struggle to be spiritual. All right? And then God will reward you openly. And sometimes the reward is not for you, it's for your family members. God needs you to be strong for your family members. Because the devil is trying to destroy your family. He's trying to destroy mine too, but the devil is a liar. And every word of God proves true. All right. So, Dean Flowers, I got a question for you about foot washing. I'm so happy because we started off foot washing. I didn't know whose feet I was going to wash, and I kind of like went to the man. Dean Flowers said, come on, Pastor.
Come on, let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it. And I love that spirit, and we got into it, and we've been doing it so long. We have joy in it, okay, because we're laboring together for the Lord. And you know what? It's not going to last forever. It has not been forever, but it's a joy right now. And so we had joy. I was able to wash his feet. He was able to wash mine. It was joy. It was a pleasure. When you kneel down in front of somebody, it just does something to you. Boy, okay. But you can talk about your kneeling. You can read about it, but kneel down in front of somebody. That is. Put your hands on their feet. Oh, that's an experience. And you need experiences with God. Not just words about God. You need to do some stuff with God.
Yes.
Okay.
Whew. That is a humbling experience, though, Pastor.
Humbling experience.
Mm-hmm. And then you want to be able to receive it and then come out with a different attitude. You know, you really do. Because I think.
Can you all hear any flowers? Can they hear me?
Speak up a little.
Yes. It does teach you to be humble. You come out with a different attitude when
you
do that.
Different attitude.
And you know, you feel uplifted. I felt uplifted when I was able to humble myself and wash my pastor's feet. I felt joy in doing that. You know, because normally I don't think I'm too proud, but I know I got pride in me.
Mm-hmm. Yep. But these flowers ain't got pride,
but to come down and do that, it was just great. And I just want to say I enjoyed that process.
I enjoyed it too.
I enjoyed it too.
Yeah. I really enjoyed it, but I enjoyed washing your feet because I see you doing things in the ministry. I see God blessing your family, and you and I have believed God to bless your family in the future.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
We talked about it when we put it out publicly, but we asking God for miracles in our family.
Amen.
And so for us to be joined in the foot washing, we joined in this, we joined in the sound. So for us to be joined in the foot washing was just an extra blessing. Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
As far as foot washing goes, what are you supposed to do or think or feel in the process of that? Are you supposed to be praying as you're washing feet? Are you just supposed to be meditating? Are you supposed to be just listening for God? What are you supposed to be doing?
All of that.
Mm-hmm.
All of that.
Yes.
All of that.
Praising, thinking.
Mm-hmm. All of that. Praying, thinking about God, just feeling, looking at the person's feet. Mm-hmm. All of that.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, some people have that little toe that go like this. They got a toe to go on. Look at their toe. It's no script. That's a good question. Because there's no script. And that's why you have to have these spiritual experiences. Because every time, it could be something different. You know, I preach every Sunday, but a lot of times when I preach, the sermons are different. And what happens to me is different. Like Sunday, I was preaching about resurrection power. While I was preaching, I hadn't had much sleep. I was tired from the week, but I was turbocharged with resurrection power while I was preaching. Okay. On Good Friday, I was talking about putting your spirit into God's hands. But again, I had not slept well. But I put everything into God's hands. And I was getting the peace from doing that. So, and like you know yourself, you've watched me many different years. Sometimes, because I told you, and I made you. All right. See, my godchildren that obey me, I make them do certain things. They don't understand why I got to do this. You ain't got to understand. I understand. And God put me over you, so do it. And Jesus told the disciples, you don't understand this now, you will later. So don't always say that I got to understand. No. Amen. You got to obey. And I'm thankful I have obedient godchildren who do things I tell them. And then one day they come to understand. But every year is different. One year, you know, you feel the burden lifted. Another year, you feel, sometimes you don't feel anything till after it's over. Like I know this year, when I was preaching, I was talking about how Jesus is with you when you're low. And I was blessed to be preaching. Sometimes I just preach and, you know, it's okay. I preach. The Lord told me to say this, I said it. But on Holy Thursday, when I preached, I was blessed. And then, before our brother Steve got there, we were singing. And we had such a good time singing. Yes. We was sounding like the choir.
Yeah. Sit.
We was just going off. Mm-hmm. All right, singing, glorifying God, having a good time. So a lot of times in the things of God, it gets different. You know, sometimes you feel it deeply. Sometimes you can do certain things. You know, and sometimes when you wash people's feet, I think the one thing you feel though, Zion, is I think you feel a sense of humbling yourself. You know, of getting down on your knees. Being humble. And then you feel the sense of other people getting humble. And that's a deep thing too. Not only are you humbling yourself, you're in a room full of humble people. You're in a room full of people who thought that it was not robbery to kneel down in front of somebody. It's just all kinds of things can happen that you can't even explain in that moment.
Uh-huh. You know, Pastor, I want to share with you too on Resurrection Sunday. Easter changes things. Mm-hmm. Digging altars. Deacon Altars and I went out after that great sermon. Easter changes things. We had to go give communion to Sister Goddard.
Yes.
And to Brother Hollis Reese.
Yes.
So the foot washing also will help you to lay hands on those that have gone through sin.
Yes, Deacon Flowers said the foot washing help you lay hands on people going through sickness.
And after we gave communion, what do you think I did? I laid hands and prayed for their healing.
Yes.
And I said, wait a minute, Lord, it's from the foot washing that I was able to. It reminded me, lay hands. Just like yes. That. It helps you to do that.
Yes, the foot washing helped you to lay hands
yes.
on those people as you yes. gave them communion.
Yes.
And here, this is the things Jesus did. He gave his communion.
Right.
He laid hands on the disciples. Right. All right. And he washed their feet. It goes into what the Lord did.
Yes.
Yeah. But one thing helps you do another.
Yes.
So, I want to encourage everybody. You know, listen, you wives, don't be afraid to lay hands on your husband. Ask him. Don't be slapping him in the head. You got to do the right thing the right way. You can't do the right thing the wrong way. All right, ask him, can I lay hands on you? Like I asked a dude in the Dunkin' Donuts, can I pray for you? And he said, yeah. Okay? Because I didn't know what was wrong with his leg. But if you sitting in front of an unknown and then you can't get out the car because of your leg, something's really wrong. Okay? He gave me $20, even though if I would go get in my car and drive off or what. But it's an opportunity to be a witness for the Lord. And the Lord wants us to do what? Be a witness. Okay? He's pleased when we share the gospel with people. He's pleased. I mean, maybe that brother never had nobody pray for him. Maybe nobody ever had any interest in him. Jesus asked people, what do you want me to do for you? Who's asking people that? Who's laying hands on people in the street? Who's praying? Might be you. And you get ready for that when you go through that experience of humbling yourself to kneel down. It opens you up. So I guess, Diana, one of the things we do when we kneel, we get opened up spiritually. And we get opened up beyond ways that we understand. We get opened up unconsciously somehow. Okay. Any other questions? Do I have any other questions? Okay. But I encourage people to have a spiritual experience. Every Sunday, I encourage you to pray. I encourage you to shout. I encourage you to think about God. I encourage you to ask yourself certain questions. Look back over your life. But I also encourage you to, you know, lay hands. Also encourage you to be laid, have hands laid on you. You know, listen, I'm laying hands on people now, but hands have been laid on me. I've been in many prayer lines. I've shouted in many churches. I've gone to many conventions, and I was in the back, I wasn't in the front. But I was in the back shouting and praising God, and that's what I want to encourage you all to do.
Amen.
Yeah, don't be a spectator, be a participator. You know, speak up for God. Watch things happen. That's when things start getting interesting. You know, be bold in your prayer. The wicked flee when nobody pursues, it says in Proverbs 28. But the righteous are bold as a lion. Be bold. Watch God. Step out in faith. It don't take a mountain of faith. It takes a mustard seed. And tell the truth, get up and be moved. Be bold in your faith. Step out in your faith. Watch God do some great things. Any other questions? Any other questions? All right. If there are no other questions tonight, because it has been such a heavy week, we're going to sign off early. How much time we got left?
6 minutes.
Okay, we're going to sign off a little bit early. TCOTOD.org to give the Wednesday night offering. Keep church going. TCOTODGIVIN is our cash app. Bless the house of God. You will never, ever give more to God than God gives to you. I want to tell you a testimony. The state government of New York and the federal government of New York told me my taxes wasn't filled out right. And my tax man, I called him, he said, I don't know, what are they saying? And I just had so much stuff going on, so many people dying. I postponed it. I said, you know, I can't worry about this. And so I was looking for my stimulus check, as people call it. My $1,400 from the government, and I didn't have it, but I had my state tax return, which was 3 times that amount.
Amen.
So I still was looking for my stimulus check, and then I went and I saw my federal tax return, which was many times that amount. And I laughed because the Lord was telling me to do some stuff with money, to pay off some bills. I always said, Lord, if I pay these bills, I ain't got no money. And the Lord said, don't always take care of you. I'm telling you to pay the bill. I was like, Lord, can I divide it up in 3 ways? The Lord said, pay the whole thing right now. And I laughed because I was looking for one check and I got 3. This is the nature of God. Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened. everyone that asks seeks, and everyone that seeks finds, and everyone that knocks finds the door is open. But you gotta try it. You gotta take a step. This is what is the great genius of black religion. It's not just in liberation. Black religion teaches us if you make one step, God will make two. And I've been making steps, and I got some other things, some great things I want God to do. And I know how to start. I gotta make a step. I gotta say, Lord, into thy hands I commit my spirit. I'm gonna step out on nothing and believe something is there. This is how I encourage you to live. Amen. Live like that. All right, we got some people staying with us. I'm so glad. Such a long day, and we had a service today. I want to thank Deacon Page again. I came in late and she ran the service, and I appreciate the perpetual readiness. Deacon Page is with us, Dakota Barnes, Sister Sharon Kennedy, Kira Satchel is with us. Kira is out in Houston, Texas. Girl, I'm glad to see your name here. God bless you. Juanita O'Garrow, Patricia Armand, Rosa Wilkerson, Deidre White, Marilyn Tucker, Kim Jones, Christine Kelwick, Elder Nick Morgan. Elder Nick Morgan went out and did a funeral for me Monday for the brother that passed, I believe in 190.
Michael?
Yes.
Michael King.
Michael King. And Elder Nick Morgan went out there and did that service. Did a wonderful job. Thank you, Elder Morgan. God bless you. I love you, my brother. Lorraine Brand is with us. And Deacon Doris Brickhouse, otherwise known as the Saint with the White Shoes. The Saint with the White Boots. All right. Everyone, everywhere is talking about those white boots of Deacon Brickhouse that I called out on Sunday. And listen, sometimes the Lord wants you to look good. You ain't glorifying God looking all busted up and messed up. You look good. Show the people what it means to be blessed. And that's what Deacon Brickhouse did. Listen, I want everybody to live by faith. I want you all to pray that we could live in this resurrection power, because the devil attacks us and the devil fights us, but the devil is a liar. Amen. Amen. I'm so glad you all came back tonight and stayed with us. Join us Sunday. Amen. And if you have not watched the foot washing service, go on the church's web, go on the church's Facebook page or my Facebook page, and you can watch it on YouTube.
Yes.
You can watch it on Facebook. You can send it to people. Send it to people so you start a conversation. And they say, what the heck is going on in your church? What are the people doing washing each other's feet? You explain to them, we're trying to do what Jesus did so we can start to change the world. Thank you all so much. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. We're looking for you on Sunday in our church school. We're looking for you in our prayer meetings. We're looking for you because God is yet moving by His Spirit. All right? Take us out with my friend. I don't own the rights to the music. Dietrich Haddon is Open Doors. Thank you, Father, for this great overflow. Bless your people. Overflow for them with your blessings. In the mighty Master's name of the Lord Jesus, we pray. For his sake. Amen. Turn it up. Let's go. The door.